relationship between two activities. So this has to finish for this to start, right? But then fast tracking means doing things simultaneously as much as possible. Even though initially you had planned to do it finish to start, but now you're fast tracking it. Right, even though it's not the best practice, but you know, you have to meet an earlier deadline, right? I mean, you come up with a schedule in the manner that you've deemed best, but then reality sets in and says, hey, great 3 month schedule, but we need to shorten it to 2.5 months. Now you have to start thinking, hey, let me compress by either crashing or fast tracking. So does crashing increase cost or not?
Yes, typically more bodies.
And typically things that you were supposed to do one after the other, but now you're trying to do it in parallel, what does that increase typically?
Risk.
Let me remind you very quickly, I'm going to go back here and do schedule compression on in and look for it. Schedule compression techniques. We first read schedule compression on page 215 of FinBok. And we said crashing increases cost. Crashing increases cost, right? And fast tracking increases risk. And I have asked you to remember that. So coming back. Fast crashing the project adds risk while fast tracking adds cost. Wrong. It's the opposite. Yeah. When you crash a project, it always shortens the total duration of the project.
Not necessarily.
Because
it's only it's a high cost.
Right. But what is another thing wrong with that?
Because
if you crash a task in the non-critical path, it will not shorten the duration. Yeah. That's why I don't like this. Crashing the project adds cost while fast-tracking adds risk. When you fast-track a project, it always shortens the total duration. What's wrong?
Always.
Because sometimes when you fast track, it may result in rework. And you know, you're trying to do something in parallel, but ideally you should have done it in sequence, and now you screwed up and you have to now go back and fix it. So the word always is a deal breaker in this question, in this answer, and in this answer.